It's time to make some cutthroat decisions. Hey guys, it's Jess from She's the Posh. Welcome back, and today under another tag video, this is 5 to keep and 5 to sacrifice. I make videos every Wednesday and Sunday, all designer and fashion related. I love sharing with you all my tips and tricks. If that is something you're into, please remember to hit subscribe below, ring my bell, so we can become best friends here on the internet. Okay guys, I'm doing this fun tag. I was tagged by Jessica from The Chic Professor. I was also tagged by someone else, may have been Tiffany from LV Coffee Lover. I'll make sure to put those videos down below. And I'm not sure who started this video, but I will do some research and put their video down below so they get the credit as well. But guys, this is a fun one. You're gonna watch me squirm. You're gonna watch me make some difficult decisions because I decided to put myself in the hot seat and I was gonna pick items that I have similar things to, pieces that are not going anywhere in my collection. However, if I had to make a decision, which one it would be, I have to pick, I have to choose. So you're gonna watch me squirm. You're gonna get a little bit of the drama. So let's get started. So I picked things that I have similar categories with. So we're gonna start with belt bags. So I have currently 2 belt bags in my collection. Both of these I have recently gotten. So which one to keep, which one to sacrifice? So for this one, was pretty easy decision on my behalf because this bag right here, I would sacrifice because this is more of a trend piece to me. This is something that I'm gonna enjoy for maybe, you know, this year, maybe I'll sell it next year. Like I like to buy fun things like that. And since I got a good deal on this one, I got it under $1,000, I figure I can sell this bag and not lose too much money on it and then move on and put it towards another fun trend piece. Whereas this bag, which I thought was a trend piece, which I thought I would never get, which thought turned me into a 90s dad, but I embraced that.
I'm a 90s dad, big whoop.
I'm loving it. This bag is so practical. I have my stuff in it and it's just super easy, practical, like hands-free lifestyle and I'm all about it. So yeah, guys, totally keep this one and I would sacrifice that one. Next, I'm gonna go with backpacks. These are 2 backpacks that I absolutely love that I wear all the time. This one I wear a lot more than I wear my Chanel. This is just more carefree, where this one, you know, careful where I take it out. It is a caviar leather, so I don't have to be too worried about it. But this one I take when I go do, you know, some mom outings, going to the zoo, going on hikes, doing different things like that. So which one to keep, which one to sacrifice? This one I do use more. This one I don't use more. However, I would pick the Chanel, because this vintage backpack, I was lucky to get this. I've had this backpack a little over a year and I got this for under $1,800. Now, if I try to get the same vintage bag, I would be paying over $3,000 for it. And it is harder to find this particular bag. So I have to keep it. It's a bag that I'll never be able to find again. And if I got rid of it, I would totally regret it. Whereas this bag, I feel like I could sacrifice it because I could find this bag again, or I could find a similar like Louis Vuitton backpack or things like that, that I could use that's durable to take out on outings. None of them are going anywhere, but I would keep this one because I couldn't find her again and I would let you go, but I would find you again. I would look for you again. Next, we're gonna go to Classic Flap, and these are 2 items. This one I've had in my collection for over 2 years, and this one I just recently got. So this one we have in the tweed and this one we have in lambskin and the classic style of being black and gold. So which one to sacrifice, which one to keep? So this one, I got such a great deal on this one. I got this under $3,000 and I knew that this would be a bag that I wouldn't wear all the time. I knew this would be just one of those fun, like collectible items that I would take out a couple times a year, but I got a great deal on it. I just thought it would just be a perfect addition to my collection, a classic piece. Now this bag here, I was lucky to get this bag for under $1,500. It was a vintage bag, it needed work done. I took it to the leather surgeons, got it completely restored. Now, this bag, if I try to replace this bag, would be over $6,000. So both bags, if I try to replace them, would be very expensive. So I couldn't do it based on that, but I decided based on what my heart would want and what my heart would miss. And so I decided to go with the vintage. I would miss this. I love the fact that I can wear this dressed up and casual. I would wear this a lot more than I would wear the tweed one, and I would miss this from my collection. So that's how I made the difficult decision that I would sacrifice you. I'm sorry, but I would sacrifice you and I would keep my vintage because, I mean, she's been around since the 90s. She likes to party. She's a good time, you know, like I can't let her go. Next, we have the Battle of the Nanos. So these two, I've had this one over a year now. This one I just added this past summer. So I only worn this one a few times, and this one I've worn a lot more. So base, there's some things I really like about this one that, I mean, you have a removable strap. I just like that it's handheld. It's a fun thing to style. And this one, you can only wear it like on the shoulder, crossbody, and it's a little bit harder to close, a little bit more fussy. Now, which one to keep, which one to sacrifice? So I decided I would keep mine away. I just love the style of this more. I would see myself wearing this more. This one is a cheaper price point. This one is more expensive with the price crease and stuff like this. This one, I think, costs around $1,400 now, whereas this one is still $1,180, I believe. But I definitely think that I would miss this one more than this one. If I had to choose, no one's going anywhere, guys. But if I had to choose, I would keep my Nano Neway bag. I just have much more fun wearing this one. It's super cute. And this one, I don't see myself wearing as much, but I love having it in my collection because it's one of those showstoppers. Just wearing this, like, top handle. How stinking cute is that moment? But yeah. Definitely with no way. And I picked my hardest decision for last. So this are the My Lulu puffer bags. Huge fans. One of my favorite bags. I've had this bag now for over a year. This bag I bought to resell. I bought this on Jama Shop because this was on sale for around, I think I got this one for a little over $1,200. And this usually retails close to $2,000. And this one retails over $2,000. I think this retails for like $22. And this one's like 19 or 18. This is a small, this is a large. Both amazing bags, love these, super cute to style. So which one do I choose? This one was hard because I don't have a color like this in my collection with this beautiful like cream and lighter color. Like it really is hitting a miss that I had in my collection. But this one here, I mean, it's gray. I do have another gray bag. It's, I just think that this one I would have to keep, and I would have to sacrifice this one because it's just, this one just brings me such joy. I was lucky to get this one under $1,500. I know if I tried to replace this, it'd be a lot more money. You can't get this color anymore. This color is a concrete gray. They do have other grays you can get with the matte, but just when I wear this one, even though it's bigger, I just love how it looks in pictures. I just love styling. I just think I look so cool. Even though I'm so not, you know, I'm a 37-year-old mom and my hair's always crazy. I never have my stuff together, but I
have my chic together
when I carry this bag. It just makes me feel cool. I do enjoy, I love this. I feel like it's been a void in my wardrobe, but if I had to, I'd keep this one. But like these bags are so great to hug. These are almost like therapy bags because you can grab them and squish them and touch them. So yeah, guys, I would get rid of this one. But you're not going anywhere, okay? It's not going anywhere. I feel so guilty, but I'd keep this one. Hey guys, that is everything. Did you feel the drama with me? Were you feeling all these difficult decisions? And I feel like I'm talking bad about like my handbag children, you know, having to choose. But at the end of the day, you know, these are just things and I could easily make decisions if I had to. So I found this very interesting. Did you guys like my take on this? I would like to tag anyone who hasn't done this because I think it's fun. It's interesting to look at your handbags in this way, especially ones that you love. If you had to make decisions, which one would you make? I'm very curious about it and your take that you do on it. So please tag me. Let me know if you do the tag. I'd love to see your video on this. And as always, guys, I want to thank you so much for watching and I hope to see you again. Bye, guys.